talking about a casual relationship. I'm not talking about having something because you just wrote the gift in the manner of life. But if everything that's left you, can you still praise God? Can you still tell him thank you? When everything went out, can you still say, God, you know what? I appreciate you because I have more now than I ever had before. You don't even see down the road. He said, I got more for you. And that's the enemy's trick, is to throw you off track before you get to your goal. Tell him, I'm going to get my more. I'm going to get my more. There is no way in the world that I want to allow anybody to keep me from getting my more. You keep praying too long. You crying all night long. There's a finished line that has to be crossed. Watch this. There's an enemy that has to be defeated. Watch this. A church that has to be built. A kingdom that has to be established. Y'all, let me tell you one more time. Let me just run back one more time. A heaven to be gained. Watch this. A hell to be shunned. A reward to be received. A dream to be fulfilled. Oh, y'all, let me know. Watch this thing. Watch this right here. A finished line to cross. A call to be answered, an enemy to be defeated, God bless America, and victors to be won. These are the things that God has in store for us, but if you tap out, you won't get your more. So here it is, when you find out, I said, I like that. This is the person that I've met from just a couple of Sundays ago. And I put that in our church, I think last Sunday. And there are three principles, there are three parts to receiving what God has in store for you. The first thing is that you got to identify the principle.
Come on.
What's the principle? What's the principle? Then you got to work the plan. If you identify what the principle is, work the plan, you get the promise. Now, this is what gets out of the way. We work the promise. But we didn't understand the principle and didn't work the plan. We thought that we were going to hope our way to the promise. But God said, you ain't work. I can't get the cross on. There's a song that says, no cross, no crown. A lot of folk want the crown, but they don't want to go through and understand what is the principle. Watch for it. What is the plan? And what promises it is. What the principle, Pastor? Again, the first thing is, watch this right here, is faith see the impossibilities. But things that we think that we can't receive, if you got faith in God, you can imagine it. But watch this right here. What dreams have you had about your future? What has God told you about you? But because the life has thrown a boomerang, a curveball, a sinker to you, it threw you off track, and you have abandoned the dream that God has given you. Watch this right here. I'm going somewhere. So faith sees the possibility in dead faith. We got too many believers that are throwing away their hopes, throwing away their dreams because of opposition, because of chaos, because of mishaps in life. But one writer says, these things come only to make us strong. I don't know.
Come on.
I can't tell you if I haven't gone through. Come on, somebody. You see, some people right now got a dream in your head. And God says, you know what? I'm going to bring that thing to pass. But because you had a setback in life, you had all but abandoned your dreams. And I came to tell you this morning, put up the black dress, put the dead flowers away, go on the coming back, call in the morning and tell them, I am not dead. Yeah, come on, somebody. I'm not dead yet. The scripture text is talking about in verse number 2. Faith sees the possibilities in impossible.
Yeah.
Now, understand this one thing. In impossible is where your promise is. Your dream has to be bigger than you. He got to lay down. Abraham, I'm going to make you the father of many nations. So when you're dead, your dream will still be living on. And when you evaluate and make sure that what I'm asking God for is not about a selfish thing, but I got to leave something for my brother, leave something for my sister, leave something for my daughter and my son and the nieces and everything. I hope them to leave something behind instead of a beetle. And you should fight on the flesh thing TV. It's, you know it's going to go in and come on somebody. And you should fight on the car because it ain't going to put on your pedestal anyway. But you have to leave something substantial for the people behind you. Try to leave something. So you have to understand that when you look at this thing, you begin to look at the power of the dream. You have to understand a few things in my spirit. The past is yours. Learn from it. The past is yours. Learn from it. The present is yours. Fulfill it. I wish you 100,000 years in the life. Well, I wish I had it done. No. Because it ain't coming back. Watch this, y'all. The future is yours, so preserve it. Knowledge is yours, so use it. If you got cancer comes and goes. But if you know a secret to cancer, cure it. Amen. Racism, end it. Come on, somebody. But don't you be buying by the ideology of thoughts of one person, but look to God, who is the author and the finisher of your life. So number one, faith sees the possibilities. Number two, faith pushes through the pain. Faith not only sees the possibility. Faith pushes through the pain. Faith pushes through the pain. Faith pushes through the pain. If no one else said a baby, you ought to say something. But y'all had a baby, y'all can be what? Push through the pain. And he's holding your hands, he's just loving, and maybe it's gonna be all right. Yeah. And then she turns to that and says, ain't gonna be all right. Sometimes I heard folks say, some bubbles have come out, some of them got cursed out, some of them got beat up, and then one that said, you will never, ever get a chance to do this to me again. I will never, ever.
Right.
same process. When he came to get them, they put nails in his hands.
Yeah.
Nails in his feet and a crown of thorns on his head. They ripped his back. And you have to understand that when a person is strong, Clark has two or three different meanings. Clark simply said that when I get through beating you, either you're going to be maimed or dead. Tell somebody. Yeah. That's the whole intention. So when you go through your tests and your trials in life, it's the inner responsibility to either disable you or kill you.
Yeah.
Come
on.
The Holy Ghost. You have to push yourself up there and say, you know what, I want to fight what's for the enemy. I got to push through the pain. Come on, I said, keep pushing. I got to push through the pain. Jesus pushed through the pain. Jesus said, I can't give up on that because I got some other souls that depend on how I react to this. You know, a lot of us, we got too quick because we don't look behind us. There's somebody saying that I can't cry, that I can't quit. Yes, you can cry, but you can't tap out like that. Amen. We have a pity party at the house, in your bedroom, in your pillow, give it to your wife, your partner. Oh, baby, I'm going to have a breakdown right now. I'm going to have my breakdown, but my I'm breaking down. I don't need you to break down. Let me break down first, and then you encourage me, and then you can break down, and I encourage you. I can't do this. I can't do this. I can't take it no more. Here's the last part. I'm going to give you one more piece right here. Then you have to understand that even if you are crippled, God says, I still can do something with you. The preacher, who was crippled? But here it is. Sir Walter Scott was crippled. Then what about if they put you in prison? Don't worry about that because God can still use you in prison. John Banner was in prison, but he still accomplished something. What if I get caught in a snowstorm in Dallas, Florida? What happens then? Don't worry about it. God will use you. Come on, George Washington. What about if I'm raised in poverty and I'm in the hood and I can't get out? Don't worry about that either because you got a witness. Abraham Lincoln can be your witness. What if I'm struggling or stricken with paralysis and I can't move? Don't worry about that either. He said, I got a Roosevelt to help you today. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. What if I'm deaf and then I can't hear nothing? Don't worry about that because I got Beethoven that can tell you, you might not hear, but you sure can play. It's a great putting a song. Come on, somebody. And let me hear this song and watch him inspire you to do better. And so you have to ask yourself whether it's racism, whether it's are you a slow learner? You got Albert Einstein, George Washington Carver that can see you through the thing that you've gone through in life. Remember this one thing. You're not the first to go through what you've been through. Now, let me just think a little bit. Because I'm glad you got your shiny there. Come on, somebody. Because here we go. This is what we say. When praises go up, blessings come down. Sometimes some folks say, you know what? I'm just going to praise my way through. But there's some things you ain't going to shout for. Unless you're going to I'm just going to give God some praise. You can give God some praise, but praise does not exempt you from going through. Praise that show God that, you know what? God, in spite of what you allow me to go through, I'm still going to give you some praise.
Yes, sir.
The last one is this right here. Faith preserves and prepares you for the prize.
All right.
Faith preserves. Now we have a high priest, which is Jesus Christ, He went through everything that you and I went through. And then he goes on, he says that he is the author and the finisher of our faith. Now, when was the last time you went back to check the book that you wrote about Jesus? When was the last time that you went back to look at the book and understand that he didn't put in the book that you was a failure, that you was a loser, that you wasn't going to win? But he did have a book that he would go through trials, he would go through tribulation, he would have some ups and downs, he would pray about it. He says, and even when you pray about it, he says, I'm not going to remove it, but my grace.
Yeah.
5.
Come on.
And look what he said on this. He said, my God. He said, this is going to be a killer and a thriller and a chiller. And I get to praising God for the people of this gorilla. I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what has you back up. But today is your day. You get the enemy thrown in the towel. Take back what he has stolen from you. Begin and finish this great meal.
Yes.
Watch what it says again. Study how he did it.
Yes.
What gave the fighter the edge over his opponent? He watched the team. You got to study the enemy. You got to know how he's going to do, what he's going to do. If you're going through and you're backing back instead of going before, you got to go back and watch to check to see how the other folks that he backed into a corner. Come here, check back, make shot, and the baby go. If you don't bow, I'll burn you. Like, don't worry about it. I studied the tape. And guess what? At the end of the day, I will.
Shout!
of a breakthrough. Yes. He said, I want you to sacrifice.
Yes.
Look, not your singing, not your shout, but get something that's going to hurt you. Give something to God that you know I can't do. I don't see it. And watch God make it work for you.
Abraham,
Sarah, God bless you. I got my nephews over here. All they know is church. Hand lights and towels and cleaning, shoveling snow and all that.
All right, now.
That's no.
We, truth be told, we didn't want to do it.
Yeah. All right.
We walked out there and fits. Valley buses and snow and all that stuff up there. God said he's going to reward
us. All right,
now. For that man, that woman that has a dream, and you know that she's about to abort it, that she's about to throw it away. I want you to stand right now. I'm going to pray for you. Yeah. There's a turnaround coming.
All right.
There's a turnaround.